Hello all of you. Yesterday we have started the chapter oscillation and I have given you the brief introduction or the basic concept behind the oscillation. In that previous session we have learned about many things like types of motion. We have seen various examples of motion like linear motion or rectilinear motion. Then rotational motion, also we have seen periodic motion. The periodic motion explanation I have given you, that the any motion which repeats itself after a definite interval of time is nothing but the periodic motion. Now similarly we have learned about the simple harmonic motion, that is linear simple harmonic motion. And one most important condition for linear simple harmonic motion is nothing but the restoring constant should be directly proportional to the displacement, that is F is directly proportional to minus X, and minus sign indicates that the restoring force and the displacement they are in opposite direction. Okay, so this is what we have seen in previous session. Also we have derived one differential equation for linear simple harmonic motion, and in that very important thing we have learned that the differential equation is, firstly we have started from F is directly proportional to minus X, and that means F is equals to minus kx, and according to Newton's second law we know that F is equals to mass into acceleration, and when we put this value we will get ma is equals to minus kx. In that we know that acceleration is the double derivative of displacement. Okay, so this m d2x by dt square is equals to minus x, and that's why d2x by dt square plus k by mx is equals to 0. Now if we consider the equation k by m is equals to omega square, and we need to put it into differential equation, and hence we will get this kind of differential equation for linear simple harmonic motion, that is d2x by dt square plus omega square x is equals to 0. So in previous session we have completed the differential equation for linear simple harmonic motion. Now we'll learn something. Suppose okay, we will take this numerical first. A body of a mass 0.2 kilogram performs linear simple harmonic motion, and it experiences a restoring force of 0.2 newton when its displacement from mean position is 4 centimeter. Firstly you need to determine the force constant, then period of SHM, that is capital T. In yesterday's lecture I told you how to calculate the capital T. Okay, then acceleration of the body when its displacement from the mean position is 1 centimeter. Now let's understand the numerical step by step. A body of mass 0.2 kilogram perform linear simple harmonic motion. Okay, linear simple harmonic motion means it is in straight line, and it is periodic motion, it is in straight line. Okay, and this force is opposite to the direction of displacement, and the force is directed towards the center or towards the mean position. Okay, so in that the body experiences a restoring force of 0.2 newton when its displacement from mean position is 4 centimeter. So the displacement is 4 cm and the restoring force, that is capital F, is 0.2 Newton. Okay, here it is indicating in small f, doesn't matter. So restoring force is F, and acceleration we will calculate. So acceleration of the body when it displaces from the mean position is 1 cm. So let's start for the force constant first. As we know, force constant is K is equals to F by X. Now we are only taking or considering the magnitude here, so negative sign gets removed. So K is equals to, that is force constant is equals to force by X, restoring force by X. So restoring force, it is given 0.2 kilogram, and displacement it is given 4 centimeter, that is 0.04 meter is equals to 5 newton per meter. So this is force constant we have calculated. Now time period, for time period we know that 2 pi by omega. Okay, this is the now this omega we don't have in this situation, so instead of omega we will write it in 2 pi is equals to square root of m by k, that is 2 pi is equals to, now we have the value of m and k also, so we are getting time period is 0.2 pi s. Then acceleration a is equals to minus omega square x, that is minus k by mx, so it is given there minus 1 meter second per second square. So this was the very simple numerical. Now let's start to calculate the acceleration and velocity and displacement for the simple harmonic motion. Now from the previous equation we have derived, that is differential equation for linear simple harmonic motion, that is d2x by dt square plus omega square x is equals to 0. That's what we have deduced already. Now let's start the further derivation for acceleration. Now we know that double derivative of displacement, that is d2x by dt square is equals to minus omega square x. So but a is equals to, we know that d2x by dt square, so a is equals to minus omega square x. Okay, so acceleration is very simple to calculate, so it is simply minus omega square x. So this is the expression for acceleration in terms of displacement. Now from the equation d2x by dt square is equals to minus omega square x, so if we separate the double derivative, so d means rate of change of displacement, so ddt by dx by dt is equals to minus omega square x. Now we know that the derivative is of dx by dt is nothing but the derivative of velocity. See, dx by dt means the rate of change of displacement, and rate of change of displacement is nothing but velocity. So simply we will write dv by dt is equals to minus omega square x. So dv by dx, suppose we consider just multiply and divide by dx, okay, so dv, and we will separate it, dv by dx, dx by dt. Now we know that dv by dx it will be as it is, and dx by dt will be v. So we will get a term over here to integrate, so v dv is equals to minus omega square x dx. So integrating both sides, what we get, integral of v dv is equals to minus omega square, it will be out of the integral, okay, then because the angular velocity is constant, and x dx. So v dv, integral of v dv is v square by 2 is equals to minus omega as it is, and integral of x is x square by 2 plus constant c, where c is the constant of integration. And let a be the maximum displacement, that is amplitude of the SHM. So when the particle is at extreme position, velocity v will be 0. Okay, when the particle, now just assume that when the pendulum is oscillating, what will happen, fro is mean position, it will have maximum velocity, but at the extreme position, okay, it will have zero velocity. So thus at x is equals to plus minus a, v is equals to 0, means amplitude is extreme. Whether it is extreme means a positive or negative. So substituting this value, we will get 0 is equals to minus omega square a square. Why we have replaced x by a? Because x is the displacement, and here we have taken displacement amplitude. The highest displacement is nothing but amplitude. So omega square a square by 2 plus c. So c is equals to omega square a square by 2. Now using this equation, using the value of c, we will get v square by 2 is equals to minus omega square x square by 2 plus omega square a square by 2. So when we remove the 2 on both sides, so v square is equals to omega square in bracket a square minus x square. So v is equals to plus minus omega square root of a square minus x square. So this is the expression for the velocity of the particle performing linear SHM in terms of displacement. So this is very important derivation here. See, simply we have derived expression for acceleration, but it is difficult to find out the derivation for velocity. So in that you need to understand, firstly you will solve it simply with the help of integration, but after that you need to put the value of C and ultimately you will get the value of V, that is velocity. So it is very important derivation here, and make a writing practice for it, so you will get easily write it down in your question paper. So for physics you will not have any option other than writing practice. Okay, so this is the equation we have get over here. So dx by dt is equals to omega square root of a square minus x square. Okay, so dx by square root of a square minus x square is equal to omega dt. Again, if we integrate in the equation, we will get sine inverse x by a is equals to omega t plus phi. Now here phi is the constant of integration. See, both times we can't take similar constant. So here we are getting this phi as a constant of integration. To know phi, we need to know the value of x at any instances of the time, the most convenient being t is equals to 0. So x is equals to a sine omega t plus phi. So this is the general expression for the displacement x for a particle performing linear simple harmonic motion at time t. Let us find the expression for displacement of two particle cases. So firstly, first case is if the particle starts simple harmonic motion from the mean position, that is for initially means time will be 0 and displacement will also be 0. So using this we get phi is equals to sine inverse x by a, which is equal to 0 or pi. Okay, so x is equals to plus minus a sine omega t. So this is the expression for displacement at any instant if the particle starts SHM from the mean position, and positive sign to be chosen if it is start towards positive, and negative sign for the starting towards negative. So in case 2, if the particle start a simple harmonic motion from the extreme position. Now for extreme position mean displacement will be higher. Okay, so a displacement is equals to plus minus a, that is amplitude, and t is equals to 0. Okay, so phi is equals to sine inverse x by a, that is nothing but the pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. So we are getting x is equals to plus minus a cos omega t. So this is the expression for displacement at any instance if the particle start simple harmonic motion from the extreme position. So these two cases are very important, that is when the particle start from mean position and for the extreme position. So just remind it, the two difference, like the difference is sine and cos. Positive sign for starting from positive extreme position, negative sign for starting from negative extreme position. Okay, so there will be two extreme positions, mean position एक प्लस एक्सट्रीम पोजीशन होगा, एक माइनस एक्सट्रीम पोजीशन होगा. जैसे कि आप ऑसिलेशन कंसीडर करिए, ऑसिलेशन में एक बार मीन के राइट में जाता है, मीन पोजीशन के लेफ्ट में जाता है सिंपल पेंडुलम. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द एक्सट्रीम पोजीशंस. सो लेट्स फाइंड आउट द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर डिस्प्लेसमेंट वेलोसिटी एंड एक्सेलरेशन. X is equals to a sine omega t plus phi, v is equals to dx by dt. So a omega cos omega t plus phi, and acceleration is rate of change of velocity. So again we will, if we take derivative, a omega square sine omega t plus phi. Now about this physics, I want to tell you one important thing, that if you are strong in mathematics, the physics will be easier for you, and if you are good in physics, the maths will be easier for you. So these two subjects go hand in hand. Okay, so if you know all the formulae for a derivation and integration, you will understand this derivative or the derivations very easily. Okay, you need to understand all the trigonometric formula and all the you have to know the formula for derivation, formula for integration, also the formula like the relationship between cos and sine and etc. so you will get it very easily what the things are going over here. Okay, so this is nothing but the derivation which we have यहाँ पे निकाला हमने अभी derive किया है. So let's solve one of the numericals. A particle perform linear simple harmonic motion of period 4 seconds. Okay, now just imagine a particle performing linear simple harmonic motion of period 4 seconds means time period means one oscillation के लिए इसको 4 seconds लगता है and amplitude 4 centimeter means the maximum displacement of its oscillation is 4 centimeter. Find the time taken by it to travel a distance of 1 centimeter from the positive extreme. That means plus a we need to consider here. So x is equals to a sine omega t plus phi. Since particle performing simple harmonic motion from extreme position, phi is equals to pi by 2, and from data we know that x is equals to a minus 1. Okay, so 3 centimeter displacement, and 3 is equals to 4 sine 2 pi by t plus pi by 2. Just we have put up all the values over here. 3 by 4 is equals to cos 2 pi by 4 into t is equals to cos pi by 2 t. So if we solve this equation with the help of logarithmic table, you will get the value. Okay, so the t is equals to 0.46 seconds. So simply in this way you can solve this all numericals. Now extreme values of displacement x, velocity v, and acceleration. So displacement, the general expression for displacement x in simple harmonic motion is x is equals to a sine omega t plus phi. At mean position omega t plus phi will be 0 or pi. Okay, now this displacement, if it is 0 or minimum, is equals to 0. So thus at mean position the displacement of the particle performing single harmonic motion is 0, and at extreme position omega t plus phi is equals to pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. And what will be the velocity? According to the equation what we have derived, the magnitude of velocity of the particle performing simple harmonic motion at the mean position x is equals to 0 and velocity is maximum. I already told you that at mean position x will be, that is displacement is 0, okay, and the velocity is maximum. So thus the velocity of the particle in SHM is maximum at the mean position, and extreme position velocity is minimum. Thus the velocity of the particle in SHM is minimum at extreme position. The very important thing you need to underline here. Then acceleration, the magnitude of the acceleration of the particle in SHM is omega square x at mean position x is equals to 0, and acceleration is also 0 at the extreme position x, so that acceleration is also maximum. Okay, in previous session also we have seen about what is mean by frequency, what is mean by amplitude and time period. So simply amplitude is the maximum distance covered by particle during oscillation, period is the time required to complete one oscillation, and frequency is the number of oscillations performed in unit time. Okay, so now here we are calculating the derivation for amplitude of simple harmonic motion. Now in this diagram you just see the two points are given, P, O, and the displacement over yahan pe diya hua hai x. Now consider a particle P performing simple harmonic motion along the straight line MN. Okay, the center O of MN is the mean position of particle. The displacement of the particle as given, x is equals to a sine omega t plus phi, the particle we have will have its maximum displacement when sine omega t plus phi is equals to plus minus 1. That is when x is equals to plus minus a. The distance a is called as amplitude. The maximum displacement of a particle performing simple harmonic motion from its mean position is called as amplitude of simple harmonic motion. Let's find out the time period. The time taken by the particle performing simple harmonic motion to complete one oscillation is called as time period, or period simply. The displacement of the particle, it is given x is equals to a sine omega t plus phi. After time t, means if we consider some time t, so t plus 2 pi pi omega, the displacement will be x is equals to a sine omega. So instead of writing t, t plus 2 pi by omega plus phi we have written here, okay. So simply we can just solve this bracket and we will get x is equals to omega a sine omega t plus phi. The result shows that the particle is at same position after a time 2 pi by omega. That means the particle completes one oscillation in time 2 pi by omega. It can be shown that t is equals to capital T is equals to 2 pi by omega is the minimum time after which it repeats. So hence its time period t is given by t is equals to 2 pi by omega. So omega square, we know that omega square is nothing but k by m. So force per unit displacement upon mass, so acceleration per unit displacement t is equals to 2 pi by square root of acceleration per unit displacement. So t is equals to 2 pi into square root of m by k. So this expression we can also solve with the help of the differential equation which we have deduced already. Okay, so this, I guess this is the somewhat lengthy procedure given over here, but simply if you go through the previous session, that is lecture number 64, you will find the derivation of acceleration, frequency and time period very simple there. Okay, just follow the instructions given in the previous chapter or previous lecture. Okay, so this is for the today lectures. We'll go to the next point, that is reference circle method. We'll learn it in the next video. So this is what we have studied over here: time period, acceleration, velocity. So in this lecture you have to know that the where will be the maximum velocity, at what point where there will be the maximum acceleration. So all these points you need to understand, and this chapter, as you can see, it is much bigger and but quite simpler. So we'll do it. Okay, so we'll meet in the next session. Till then, goodbye and take care.